So, here we are. I just finished it, and there's a head, there's a painting. So, it's probably one of the best heads. It is actually the best head I've painted. As you see, it's a lot of detail. I always build it as a sculpture. Of course, it's not photorealism. It's supposed to be a painting. So, of course, photorealism is painting too, but that's not the goal. And this little conchilia here. This is actually a commission, and it's a long time since I painted something like this, and it was fun to be doing a lot of from photographs lately. I used to do much more of these still lifes before, but I guess it's time to start doing it again, because it was... You learn a lot from it. It's like building a sculpture, or you... There's a more 3D dimension if you do it live. And you have to press your instruments, your eyes and your abilities more. That's... Yeah. Okay. See, it's a lot of layers. In the end, I use a lot of... almost watercolor, and it's oil, but I water out with the turpentine and oil to get it transparent. And yeah, and it also brings out the textures and stuff. Overpainted it many times. That's the whole thing. You have to keep on working with it until it comes out, until it has that 3D effect. That's my opinion anyway. That's how I like it. So yeah, I guess that was it. Yeah, that's the head. It's really starting to smell. I've had it in my freezer for years. Maybe I should let it rot in a shallow grave so I can use the bones. Anyway, yeah, so it's Saturday night, 28th of February 2005. It's love. Yeah, anyway, I get a lot of questions about painting. I have a group on Facebook, so you can add yourself in. You find it underneath this video, and if you want to communicate, you can ask me a question there. Or if you want to add me as a Facebook friend, you send me a private message and like one of my pages and invite some friends to it, and I add you. Only if you do that. I will ignore you if you don't, because I want to know which people I add on Facebook. Okay. Yes, there will come more videos soon, so stay tuned. Uh, 2015, of course, not 2005. Yeah. Somebody asked me what colors I use, and as you see, I use the primary colors. From the yellows to the reds, that's kind of kaplak or alizarin. It's cadmium red, cadmium orange, cadmium yellow, cadmium and that totally yellow thing, cadmium, what's it called, cadmium, cadmium yellow light, it says. And I use Old Holden. And I use Winsor & Newton, and yeah, and I have kind of I use ivory black, and and cobalt blue, cobalt, and ultramarine, ultramarine blue. It's kind of to give easier to, instead of mixing everybody, all the colors. It's yeah, cadmium red, donker. I kind of used the Goethe's Fargelehre. You just have to study Goethe and a color circle, and kind of use the same palette as the impressionists. Work in the same way as nature does with light, in a way. Of course, I use whites and yeah. And the brushes I really like to use is actually not expensive. It's Da Vinci, called Da Vinci. I like this. And I have all sizes. You can buy in the store. So not too expensive. No. I burn through a lot of pencils when I'm painting. I don't buy the most expensive ones. I buy expensive colors though, because that's the most important thing. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Hope it's helpful. Okay. Ta-da. Hello, YouTubers. I'm going to start a new painting today. It is of sheep's head, very hard light on it, as you see. I set light right straight on it like that. I'm gonna paint it on this canvas live, and point is, the reason why I do these things is basically because it's interesting and it's a good training to teach my eyes to see shapes and stuff. I do a lot of stuff from photographs, especially models. I also have done a lot of model painting, directed from models earlier, but lately I've been doing much from art photos that I take myself, because I like to get more done. It's easier. But anyway, I'm gonna do this today on this canvas. And there was some people on YouTube and Facebook that has asked me what I use as a grounding. And what I do is that I can actually explain it. So what I do is I buy already grounded canvas, but as we see, there's a lot of texture here. So what I do is I use this gesso, and it's kind of just white. Ah, shit. Yeah, whatever. White like this. It's quite thick. And what I do is I first just put the canvas up on the frame, and I use this this one, and I usually lay one or two layers of this gesso upon this to kind of cover the texture, so it becomes more manageable. And you can also actually, when you ground it, you can use you can make actually textures in the grounding by do like this before. But then after that, I use this raw umber. Anyway, raw umber, Winsor & Newton, because it has the nicest color. It's kind of neutral. Then I have just take a piece of paper, just put some spots around, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or maybe 4,
And then I use just paper with turpentine and just kind of do like that to get this darker color. Because when I'm painting, I was starting to kind of begin with a lightest points on it. Like I start here, and I have this little conchylia in it too. It's kind of quite funny. Actually, this painting is actually a commission. But I'm really looking forward to start doing these things again, because it's a long time since I did a head. I'm also gonna start doing some self-portraits from mirrors and some objects, and maybe make some videos, especially making a video of a self-portrait when I'm painting self-portrait. Yeah, it's a long time since I did that. Maybe 7 or 8 years since I did a self-portrait, so I guess I'm getting old, so I should start doing it before I become too ugly. yeah, and this was segment number one, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, one thing. I also use not so expensive, but really good. It's Da Vinci. It's a swine brush, a swine bust, or whatever you call it. And they are quite nice. They're nice to work with. You get them all sizes. Leaves, textures, and yeah. Okay, there we are. So, I'm gonna make a small video, a short video, where I kind of show you how I do it. My mother always tells me why I give away this stuff for free, but I think it's kind of a giving something away is good thing. I mean, the reason why I'm painting is because some people affected me. Not actually thought me, because I'm kind of self-thought, but I learned to paint myself from watching and looking at pictures and starting to understand painting. I went to an art school and learned the basics, but I didn't actually learn how to paint there. I need to get this into the middle, but as you see, I start with just points. I just find the right points, like the mirrors here, the little shell thing is there. There's a line behind, like this. And then when I just start to fill it out. It's kind of strange to talk to a camera, but it's in a way it pleases me to know that some people are getting something out of it and maybe learn something from it. And I mean, if you can help someone to move their painting along, or maybe inspire them, I think it's a nice thing. One has to learn how to paint. I can't teach anyone to paint, really. I can just show them some basics. I need another pencil. How I start and how I think and how you should think when you're painting. So it's all about seeing and understanding texture. I mean, if you want to understand texture, texture, you have to look at Rembrandt. I would say Rembrandt blank. It's hard to paint and talk at the same time. Turner, I think Turner, and we have to look at Vermeer. And not actually looking at the what's in the painting, because that is not the point. You have to look at what, how it's painted. Understand how they think, how you put down all the texture. How you kind of just finding it like this and just keep on working, because we are all human and we can basically learn everything. Anyway, maybe there are some people who are better at some things, but we can't know who it is until they've done the work. So this talent thing is quite ridiculous, because you can't know who has a talent for anything. I would say humans have a talent for everything, and we also have a talent for being stupid. And you just have to learn how to follow our needs and dreams and just keep on doing it until it start to become something. I was 21, almost 21 or 22 when I started to paint. I used to be a welder, and it was just coincidences that I started doing this. And when I started out, I was drawing like a 10-year-old. But I always had this gift for being a fanatic in everything I do. It could be martial arts or in whatever it was. It's always this going into things with full, all of me. Put in everything. So you might say that people who can actually bring it to some higher level need a this fanaticism in them. They are willing to do the work and don't give up. People come to me and say, "Oh, can you teach me how to paint?" Nah, I can show you some things, but you have to do the work yourself. It's not, you can't actually learn to paint from anyone. You have to observe and understand. Yeah. Now, it has a funny thong coming out of its mouth here. And under here, it's like... Can you see this?
Yeah. Yeah.
And... to me, it's, painting is my life, and it's what I love. If I don't do it, I get quite depressed and feel that life is so good. And if I don't do stuff, I get bored and I get depressed. And not a good thing. Painting makes me happy, and that is basically why I do it, because painting just makes me happy. So simple. I remember a film, Basquiat. I think that Basquiat did was just babble, but what's his name? Well, there's an actor there who is playing Gary Oldman. Gary Oldman. The actor Gary Oldman plays another artist, and Basquiat asks him how he can paint all the time, how he can get something done all the time. He just says, well, because I love painting. And that was the only reason he needed to do stuff. He didn't need a reason, an idea or anything. He just needed painting, the painting itself. And if you understand that, and you just don't try to be an artist or try to do all this solipsistic artist chatter, forget it. If you want to do something, just do it. Do it because you like it. And it's like scientists, they love science because they love the challenge. And that is basically the reason why I do it too. I just love the challenge. And I think it's the only reason we need. It's pure love. Usually I play loud music or some documentary or some audiobooks in the background to kind of learn something while I'm painting. But especially when I play music, I get high. And I bring with me this feeling of being happy for days if I really connect with what I do. And don't try to find yourself. You're already there. You just have to start using yourself. You're already there. It's a funny thing that people say, I'm going to find myself. I need to find myself. But how can I find something that's already there? You just have to do it. In a way, we can control a little bit where we end up. And that is by focusing on the things we want to do. Actually, I saw a poll about the people that were dying regretted the most. And it was always the same thing. And always the things they didn't do. The things they dreaming about them. And life is short, too short. It's like horrible. I'm 46 years old now. And I wonder many times what the hell happened to 26 and 36. On average, I have now 34 more years to live. Just have to use the rest of it for something constructive. I don't even ask why anymore. Why? Shut the fuck up. Just do. Try to create something beautiful. Do I think it matters after I'm dead what I did? Well, not for me. I'll be dead. So it's really all about now. Being now. And this is what gives me of meaning. It's very much alive here. Sorry for my poor English.
I'm better when I'm talking to people.
It's like talking to the hand. And it's quite annoying. It's hard to concentrate when I'm talking, so I'm just gonna leave it at that. I'm just gonna make a video of the whole process with some, maybe some music this time. Classical music, maybe Rachmaninoff, something like that. I love Rachmaninoff. It's very complex. I would actually love to learn how to play the piano. But I think that train has left the building, so just have to focus on this and get better. Anyway, if you have any questions, yeah, that was warm. Oh, the horror. If you have any questions, you can find me on Facebook and can join my group. And if you want to be a Facebook friend, you first have to send me a private message. Tell me who you are. And then I will probably add you. And you have to like my pages on Facebook. I have two pages. You have to like one. At least. And I have a group so we can communicate more directly. So, I guess I'm gonna stop ranting and start painting. You see what I do? I just kind of line it up and I just work, I line it up, try to get it into the center, get the composition right, and then I just start molding it like it was clay. I just start building and building and building and building and building and building. When I have one layer, I let it dry, then I take a lazure with some bluish, reddish color over the whole thing. Just remove the tops of it and then paint over so you get more color into these small textures and stuff like that. So that's how I do it. The eye. I had the honor of painting the last surviving Holocaust victim in Norway just now. Huge painting. There's a video of the whole process, 6.5 hour. yeah. Why not? So it was an honor to meet a person who also has used his life to tell the story and lost 19 family members in Auschwitz, picked himself up, and used his life for something constructive. And that is, he should be an example for us all. If he could do it, we can do it. So, stop whining. Start working. Okay, cool.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, I guess you managed to come through the video. Here you can see the still life and the finished head, how it turned out. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. It took me a while to make it, and it's kind of nice to listen to music while I'm painting, so you get both in this video. You can see me talk and you can see me paint to music and everything. And it's a lot of detail work, so I hope you learned something. If you want to support my channel, you can go to Patreon and sign up for $1.05, and I will teach you how to paint and also add you on Facebook so we can communicate more directly. Hope to see you in the next video, and give a thumbs up.